Hi there, and welcome to another review for Guitar Interactive magazine. My name's Rick Graham. And what we're going to do today is we're going to have another look at a Wampler pedal, and this time it's the SLOstortion. This particular distortion pedal is based on the classic Soldano SLO or SLO 100 head, which was made in the mid-80s by Mike Soldano. And out of respect that Brian Wampler has for Soldano being able to capture these fantastic distorted tones that were so evident on some 80s and 90s recordings, what he's done is try to capture this amp and put it in a pedal. So what we're going to do is we're going to explore it and try and get some decent tones, which I'm pretty sure we'll be able to do. And what I'll do is, as in every review, I'll take you through the features of the actual pedal itself. According to the Wampler website, it's made of high-grade film capacitors and resistors. It's a true bypass pedal and has a three-band EQ. Also, there's a boost switch with the pedal too, which you can actually use independently. So just on when you've bypassed the pedal, you can use the boost on your clean sound or whatever sound you've got coming from the amp. So that's an extremely useful feature. And we also have a switch which enables us to flick from crunch and overdrive tones just at the flick of the switch there. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of tones we can get cooking with this. So let's take a look at the controls on the actual pedal itself. Let's take a look at those controls on the pedal. We start at the top left, we have the volume control. Adjacent to that, in the center, we have the switch for the crunch and overdrive settings here. And to the right of that, we have the gain control. These two LEDs also indicate whether the pedal is actually on itself or bypassed. That's this LED on the right, which is a blue LED. To the left of that, we have the red LED, which indicates whether the boost is engaged. Okay, so we start here underneath with the boost control. That controls the level of the boost when the boost is engaged. And then adjacent to that, we have the three-band EQ with treble, middle, and bass. And of course, we have the two main switches here, which is controls the on-off of the pedal itself and the boost. Right, let's check out some sounds with this pedal. So here's our clean sound. The first thing I'm going to do is engage the boost. And as I said before, you can use this independently so that you can actually boost just that clean channel. So here's our clean channel again. I'll just turn the boost level down slightly. So here's our clean channel again. And if I engage the boost, independent from the main pedal itself, so that's a really, really nice feature in my opinion, just that separate boost on its own. We'll get to that as well when essentially for using it in a sort of a solo situation, so we'll get to that a little bit later on. So let's engage the pedal itself and we'll try some crunch tones to start with and see what we can get. I'm just going to make some settings changes here. So at the moment they're all at 12 o'clock, so I'm just going to add a little bit of middle, touch of treble, and turn the bass up a little. And the gain is at 12 o'clock. Okay, nice. Let's turn the gain up a little bit. So I've got it at 3 o'clock now. tasty. I'm liking that sound. So what I'm going to do now is just change some of the EQ settings a little bit. So let's turn the treble up all the way. Take the middle down a little and turn the bass back a little. Just going to turn the gain up a little bit more. Yeah, I'm definitely liking this. Okay, so let's make some more changes. So far at the moment, I've just been using the crunch setting. So let's engage the overdrive setting and turn up the gain. I'm gonna start with the gain actually at 12 o'clock. Return the treble back a little bit, add a bit of mids. Okay. Let's add some more gain into the mix. That sounds really smooth and creamy to me. Very, very impressed with that tone right there. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to engage the boost. So what you're going to have to do here is, in that particular scenario, say you're doing a solo in a band situation, you want to alter that boost, independent boost level, so that it's balanced just right. Otherwise it's going to be, you know, either too quiet or too loud, essentially. So here's our regular signal. Engage the boost. So it gives a really, really nice boost to that signal so that you cut through during a solo section. Yeah, I dig this pedal a lot. Very, very nice. Okay, so let's roll the gain back just a touch. And what I'm going to check now is I'm going to roll the guitar volume down just to see how well it responds and cleans up. I'll disengage the boost there. So with the gain around about the 10 o'clock mark here, I'm just going to roll the guitar volume off to see how it affects it. That responds really, really, really well. It cleans up really nicely. Very, very impressive pedal this so far. So essentially what this pedal can do is take you through a variety of different sort of distortion sounds. But all you essentially need is just your own amp and this box, and pretty much you can get a variety of different tones going just with that alone. So I think Brian Wampler needs congratulation for this, because I think personally it's a fantastic pedal. So I would advise you to check it out as soon as you can, if you're in the market for this kind of pedal. And as I said before, this is based on that Soldano 100 that was so popular on a lot of guitar-orientated albums, especially in the 1980s. So I think this recreates that tone exceptionally well. So this wraps up this review for this fantastic pedal. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.